algorithm. It is one of the fastest algorithm in symmetric key cryptography. It is more faster than the DES algorithm. So it is more effective than the DES algorithm as well as the triple DES algorithm. Okay. Now, what is the specialty of this Blowfish algorithm developed by Bruce Schreiner is, it will take the block size, the input block size, that is the plain text, as 64 bits. Whereas it is having a variable size of key. If you take the AES and the DES algorithms, the key size is fixed. For example, in the DES, it is 56-bit key. In the AES, it is 128 or 192 or 256. But here, in the Blowfish algorithm, the key size is variable. That means it will have key size of for each round will be from 32 bits to 448 bits. So therefore, variable size. And the number of subkeys are stored in an array called as the P array. What is a subkey? A key that is used for the round function is said to be the subkey. Okay. So that is stored in a concept called as the P array. That is again a matrix representation in the forms of rows and columns. And the total number of rounds, here also we have got rounds. Total number of rounds involved in the Blowfish algorithm is 16. Okay. And there are four substitution boxes, S boxes, that contains 512 32-bit entries. Each entry will contain 32-bit. Like that, there will be 512 entries. Do you understand? There are four S boxes. S boxes means a matrix representation for rows and columns, in which each row and each column will contain 32 bits. Like that, there will be 512 entries. So these are the parameters that are used for Blowfish algorithm, which is also a symmetric key block cipher algorithm. Can you understand? Now coming to the structure of Blowfish algorithm, here the encryption process begins with a block size which is of 64 bit plain text, as I told you, and there are totally 16 rounds. In each round, we are making use of the 16 P arrays. P arrays contain the keys. Subkeys are stored in the P arrays. So totally 18 subkeys are used. 16 will be used for round functions and 2 will be used for post processing. Okay, so the 64-bit plain text will be the input for the encryption, and it undergoes round number 1, in which the first P array will be used. Then that output will be given to the second round, in which the second P array will be used. Like that, it continues for a total number of 16 rounds. Okay, then after which we have got the post processing. After the 16th round, we've got the post-processing, and after the post-processing, you will get the output, that is 64-bit ciphertext. This is the entire process of encryption in Blowfish algorithm. Okay. Now, how do we generate the subkeys? I told you there are totally 18 subkeys that are used and stored in the P arrays. We are naming it as P array. Okay. So it is named it as P0, P1, P2, ... P17. Okay. Now each array element will be 32-bit size. The entry for each array element will be 32-bit. Okay. Now it is initialized with the step 1 of the Blowfish is there are keys used. Therefore, the first step 1 for Blowfish algorithm is generation of subkeys. What is a subkey? A part of the key is said to be the subkey. How many subkeys we are using in the Blowfish algorithm? It is minimum 32, and it ranges from 32 bit to 448 bits. So from that 448 bits variable size, we are taking 32 bit entries containing, we call it as P arrays, and totally 18 such P arrays are used, which is known as the subkeys. Okay, so the P arrays or the subkeys are used for or involved in the each round function. Okay, now how do we get this P array? So if we initialize the value of pi 22/7, there is no end. Okay, so we initialize the value of, we use the value of pi, that is 22/7, and the P array number 0, that is P0, P1, P2, etc., will contain the hexadecimal representation of the subkeys. What is the hexadecimal representation? Which contains 0, 1, 2, 8, then after 9. After that, we have A, B, C, D, etc. Okay, so that is what the hexadecimal representation. So totally there will be 18 such P arrays which will be used. So we are using the P arrays starting from P0 to P17. Okay. P0 to P17. So P0 will contain an hexadecimal value, P1 will contain hexadecimal, like that P17 will be containing the hexadecimal value. This is what the generation of subkeys. Okay. The second step is initializing the S boxes. How many S boxes we are using? S box means substitution box. There are 4 substitution boxes which are using, starting from 0 to S0 to S1, S3, S4, S3. This S boxes will be used by both encryption and decryption process. Each S box contains 256 entries, that is S0 to S255, totally 256, where each entry is 32-bit. I'll show you the S boxes. So there will be 4 such S boxes which will be initialized in the at the beginning. This is the second step. The third step is only we go to the encryption process where the round function is involved. So each, I told you, there are totally 16 rounds. Okay. Now, how does the round function take place? Means it will take the input plain text and divide it into 2 halves. What is the size of the input plain text? 64-bit. So it divides into 2 halves, that is 32-bit and 32-bit. One is called as the XL, left half. Another is called as the XR, that is the right half. And one part will be perform XOR operation, exclusive OR operation. That is A XOR B is A B bar plus A bar B. So here A is 1 half, that is XL. And B is the P array, that is first subkey P0. It will be XORed. Can you understand? The value of A XOR B is A B bar plus A bar B. So here what is A? 32-bit XL. Then what is B? 32-bit P array subkey. So both will be XORed to produce a result which is also 32-bit. This result will undergo a function, which is the round function, with the right part, that is the right half or the second part of the plain text, that is XR. Okay, then you get a result. This function I'll explain. Then you get a result. This result will again undergo this procedure until for 16 rounds. Is it clear? So in every round function, there will be a function and there will be a, first it will be divided into 2. Then we add the subkey XOR using the XOR operation. Then it undergoes a function F. Then again, we get 2 halves where these 2 halves will undergo the next round function. Like that, the process continues for 16 rounds. Okay. Now, what is the function F doing, which is there in the structure of the blowfish? What does it do? The F function takes the input. What is the size? The result, XORed result of 32 bit of plain text and the PRA. PRA is the subkey. Okay, the subkeys are stored in the P arrays. So the result is also 32 bit, where it will be divided into four equal parts. Therefore, one part contains 8 bit. So 4 into 8, 32 bit. Here only we will be using the S-box concept, that is substitution box concept. What is a substitution box? Substitution box is a representation of 32-bit entries, okay, which is in the form of rows and columns, and that will be used for only for the round function of Blowfish. Okay, now each part, there are totally how many parts? Four parts are there. Four part consisting of 8-bit each. Let us name it as XA, XB, XC, XD. The first part will undergo S box. I will have an addition with S box one. That is first part and the second part will have an addition, binary addition. Okay, that result will be XORed. You can function that result will be XORed with the third X box. Can you understand? The 8-bit first part will be stored in the or connected with the S box number 1. That is 32-bit. That S box number 1 and S box number 2 will be added. Simple addition. S box 1, S box 2. This is what I am saying is F of, function of, F of. You write now, I will write it and show it to you. F of S1 S1 plus S2. What is S2? Array 2. So F of S1 plus S2, then XOR S3. What is S3? Substitution box number 3. So what is the operation XOR plus with the circle? That is a XOR symbol. Okay. Now, what is the meaning for this? XOR means the both input should be of same size. A and B should be of same size. That is the meaning for the XOR operation. Okay, now the result of S1 plus X2 will be XORed with the third substitution box, that is S3. Can you understand? So S1, S2 we will get. That will be XORed with third. Again, the next part, that is S4, which contains the combination of one part of the input plain text, with which is stored in the S box number 4, will be again added. Okay, with the result of S3. So finally you get 32-bit output. 32-bit output. Okay, so this is what the function F which is doing in the each round. You can see this is the function which is done in the round function, this round function. Okay, 1/2 we are taking. If you don't know, once again I'll repeat. First thing, what we are doing, we are taking the 64-bit input plain text that is divided into two halves, 32-bit and 32-bit. We name it as XL and XR, suffix L, suffix R. Then it is, for one part is XORed with the first array, that is P0. What is it? P array. P array contains a subkey. What is the size? 32-bit XOR. That result we are giving it to the function to be performed, which is named as F. What is that function doing? That function divides the 32-bit into four parts of equal size. Then it adds it with the four S boxes. We are using four the S boxes here only. Substitution box, which contains 32-bit entries, totally 256 entries will be there. Okay, these are values. Then S box 1 and S box 2 is added, F of S1 plus S2, XOR S3. Understand? Okay, the result will be XOR. That is why this arrow mark is like this. Then that result is again added with the S4, substitution box number 4, to get 32-bit output. Can you understand? Now this process continues for every round. Again, this result is given as output to the right half of the plain text, that is also 32-bit, that is XORed. Then you get 32-bit XL and 32-bit XR. This also again undergoes number round number 2, round number 3. Like that, totally 16 rounds will be performed for getting the 64-bit ciphertext. So these are the four important steps as far as the Blowfish algorithm is concerned. Number one is actually mainly three things. Number one is the generation of keys, generation of subkeys. Number two is initializing the S boxes. And third one is encryption, in which the round function is important. Okay, these are the steps for Blowfish algorithm. Can you understand? You just take down the diagram. This diagram, all of you, make a note. Make a note of this diagram.